Hi, Theo here. In this video, I'll show you how to scrape structured data from Facebook Marketplace by location, category, or specific search query. You'll be able to extract listing details like price, description, images, delivery info, seller data, location, and listing status using a tool called Facebook Marketplace Scraper. Here's what you can do with it. If you're reselling, flipping, or deal hunting, scraping helps you back prices, spot trends, and catch underpriced or free items early. Looking for a rental or house? Compare listings across cities, check historical prices, and avoid wasting time on overpriced options. Selling on Marketplace? Analyze top-performing listings, optimize keywords, and price competitively. For businesses, scraping enables competitor tracking, dynamic pricing, real estate research, fraud detection, and brand protection, like spotting counterfeit or unauthorized listings before they do damage. The best part is you don't need to jump through hoops to get this data. Facebook Marketplace Scraper makes things simple. No login, no cookies, no browser extension. It runs in the cloud, and you can export results in JSON, CSV, Excel, or use the API. Let's see how it works. First, head to the link in the description, which will take you to Facebook Marketplace Scraper's README. Click on Try for Free, which will send you to the login page, and you can get started with a free Apify account. Don't worry, there's no time limit on the free plan and no credit card required. After logging in, you'll land on the Actors Input page. While you can configure this through either the intuitive UI or JSON, we'll stick with the UI option to keep it easy. For scraping Facebook Marketplace, you'll need the URL from Facebook. You can use a URL of a search term, location, or an item category. For this tutorial, we'll go with an iPhone. So let's open up Facebook Marketplace, input a search term, and then copy the URL from the toolbar and paste it in the input. You can add more via the Add button, edit them in bulk, or import the URLs as a text file. Next, you can limit how many posts you want to scrape, and that's it. Before running your actor, it's a great idea to save your configuration and create a task. This will come in handy for scheduling or integrating your actor with other tools, or if you plan to work with multiple configurations. Now that we have the input, let's run the actor by hitting Start. You can watch your results appear in Overview or switch to the Log tab to see more details about the run. Now that your run is finished, we can get the data via the Export button. You can choose your preferred format and select which fields you want to include or exclude in your dataset. Then just hit Download, and you have your dataset file. Let me show you what this looks like in JSON format. If you want to automate your workflow even more, you can schedule your Facebook Marketplace Scraper to run at regular intervals. Choose your task and hit Schedule. You can set the frequency of how often you want to run the actor. You can even connect your actor to other cloud services, such as Google Drive, Make, or any other Apify actor. You can also run this scraper locally via API. You can find the code in Node.js, Python, or curl in the API drop-down menu in the top right corner. To learn more about retrieving data programmatically, check out our video on it. Need more Facebook or Instagram data? Check out our other scrapers in Apify Store. We have dozens of meta scrapers, links in the description. If you prefer video tutorials, we have a playlist covering different Instagram scraping use cases. And that's all for today. Let us know what you think about the Facebook Marketplace Scraper. Remember, if you come across any issues, make sure to report them to our team in Apify Console. If you found this helpful, give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Don't forget to hit the bell and stay updated on new tutorials. That's all for now. So long, and thanks for all the likes.